Hello, I'm Garrett Kody, Battalion Chief of Operations with the Hanover Park Fire Department, a suburb of Chicago, and I'm here today to show you our brand new engine company number 16. This is our third vehicle that we have purchased from Pierce. We're pleased with their overall service, the product that they deliver, and more specifically the cab, in which we really are happy and pleased with what they are able to do for us. So let's go ahead and we'll give a walkthrough. We went again with an Enforcer cab. One of the things that we have always looked for is embracing that extra space in which we can store things. So we did go with the compartment over the wheel wells, which most companies and most fire departments are going with. We can use that to store our EMS equipment. What we're proud of for this particular engine is we have switched to riding forward. For years we were always riding backwards, and we did make the push with this apparatus to face forward. You can see we have the two forward facing seats. We do have an ample supply of, a large volume of compartment space in which to hold all of our EMS equipment. This is an ALS, or Advanced Life Support equipped engine. And what else we are happy with this particular engine is the 84-inch cab, the larger cab. We had went with the compartments down here in which to embrace some aspects of that clean cab initiative. We are going to put the turnout gear here for our firefighters that engineer, the officers, the backstop will be in this area, as well as a general complement of some very basic hand tools. Get them out of the cab, get the firefighters and the officers not having to be with their gear inside of the cab. I went to 2,000 gallon per minute Hale pump. It is a pump panel. Not much else to it other than the fact that it pumps water, right? Compartments. Like a lot of other our contemporaries, we had gone with a reversed hinge to open to the engineer's compartment, where all the engineer appliances, extra things will go. Makes it easier for the engineer to have notes if we need to put some documentation on the door. Went with the gear grid swing out for other various hand tools for the firefighters. And one of the things that we're proud of and what we have done is we took a lot of time to look at what is an engine company, what is the function of an engine company, to get away from all of that extra stuff and fluff, extrication tools, everything that we had carried in the past, and gone to what is the mission of an engine. So we have a little bit lower profile, a little bit smaller body. We focus more on the back end here. Like a lot of departments now, we went with the booster reel, which what was old is now new again, or what they had done 30 years ago, we're getting back to doing the booster reel for those nuisance fires. Hose bed is a hose bed. We went with the aluminum tread plate cover. What we ended up doing, or what one of the engineers here at Pierce, Mr. Craig Olive, was able to do for us, is we were able to lower the hose bed, deepen it, as well as increase the size of the dunnage up on the top, just by having the engineers here at Pierce take a look at our spec prior to pushing it through. I'd recommend anybody that's building a vehicle here at Pierce, bring the engineers in, bring your fleet people in, because they can help you utilize some space that you may not have otherwise seen or been thinking of utilizing. All right, and now on the officer's side of the vehicle, looking at the compartments, just standard compartmentry for the rest of the vehicle. This engine will carry a very basic combination Maverick hydraulic tool for some light auto extrication before we get our auto aid partners in to help us. We do have a small compartment up above the wheel wells. At this point, we're thinking we're going to be putting in our high-rise packs, hotel packs up in this area. The ladder rack does extend down. One of the things that we have found over the years is having a two-arm ladder rack is what works. It lessens the fatigue. Again, looking at the officer side, here is that compartment in which we are going to put the turnout gear. We also have a slide-out tray in which we will be putting on our EMS equipment, ballistic vests, a stair chair for EMS. We do have a lot of space in which for that to work. Again, the officer side here for compartmentry above the wheel well in which to store their turnout gear, to store their protective equipment. The front end of our vehicle, we have the engine 16 in the grill. You also see that we have the Wayland Dominator light also in the grill. We are going to be putting that into for those fans of the 1980s show Knight Rider, we do have a light pattern that will bounce back and forth like kit, the Knight Rider car. And we do have a rocker panel in the engine that denotes it as such. Mars 888 light, this is something that we have been adding here in Hanover Park for the last three or so vehicles moving forward. It is something that is unique to our area and we like it. When we look at the front bumper here, we went from what we had had traditionally was a cutout or a groove, a compartment, something in which to hold our hose line, hold our engineer's bag. We went with the flat featureless front bumper because we are going to be putting on 150 feet worth of supply line. We do have some areas in town or multifamily that do have some longer lays into the hydrants. Up front, two air horns, we have a rumbler siren in the center, and the federal cue. I mean, we had talked about the brow light, we talked about the Dominator being the kit pattern, the Mars light, the green and red lights to reflect the Chicagoland area, which Hanover Park is a suburb of. Again, thank you for watching the video. Before I go, I'd like to thank everybody that was involved in this vehicle. There's a number of people, both in the village and the fire department, as well as the build team from Public Works. Everybody that was a part of this put in a lot of hard work to make what we feel is a very good fire engine. Thank you again for Pierce. And thank you again, Pierce Manufacturing.